She crescendoed to the E, the top E in the second measure. There's a sense of finality to it. And she used what?
Vibrato.
Short note vibrato right there. So there's a degree of like musical maturity right here. That was great. And so what I want to encourage you to do is find those musical nuances in the rest of the etude, because like that was exceptional. The other stuff was well executed, but sometimes we got to do a little bit more to work this out. A good example would be in the fourth measure, the fourth line, first measure, because we can shape this. Right now, I kind of hear just sort of stagnant. It's flat. And I actually think you can go. Can I hear that? G, 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 F sharp. Think about the musical finesse that you can play with. I think that helps it. Can I hear it from there? Yeah, I like that. Now, when we tongue, the clarity is good, but it's a little bit heavy. I think we're using a little too much tongue. Can I hear this legato tongue again? Or legato tongue this time again, because I've been saying it a lot this class. It is a broad sound. Saying open here. Good. Now all we're going to do is make them a little bit crisper, but everything else is the same. Can you do a little bit more of this? More crescendo. Beautiful. It's great. And then sort of similarly, when we get to something like this, I want to hear like a really convincing crescendo. So there's an arrival there. So what dynamic do you hear? What's it mark? Okay. Yes. Excellent. So you know, the thing is, it's just about maximizing the things that you're already doing, really trying to find the nuance here. Now, I have one little trick you might consider, and it's in the last measure. And one of the challenging things is getting that low B to respond. So I want to do some strategies. The first is on the, if you find in the etude, one, two, three, four, the fourth to last note, to G sharp, I would actually probably finger that with the low B key. And I would keep that low B key down up until the E. And I think one is like, it makes it a little bit easier. So part of the problem here is we got a lot of pinky motion. So you can eliminate that if you just use the B key here and sustain it. So could I hear you slowly? And use the low B key for that G sharp. sharp. Stop on it as if it's the last note. So can you play from here and then just sustain the low B? Big sound. Yeah, and then here's the thing on the saxophone. Remember I just alluded to it being sort of naturally abrasive and low register. Remember that? Listen to the difference in sound here. Sure, I agree. Like, to me, like, one is, like, buzzy, and the other is less buzzy. and really what I'm doing is I'm keeping this clutch. It's supporting the corners and not being too taut with the air stream. And I think that's what you want here. Could I hear you exaggerate the difference? Could I hear... Some direction. slur just there this time. And make sure when you get to the long note, there's a crescendo. I kind of hear a little decay at the end. I hear, and I want to hear, drive forward. Yes, and now in the articulation. Makes all the difference. It's better clarity, and now like there's musical motion here. You're doing an awesome job. Congratulations.